Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We have a short one, but kicking off today's video, SpaceX launched another batch of Starlink satellites with the Starlink 3-4 mission earlier today.
Ignition and lift off of Starlink 3-4, go Falcon 9.
The booster which launched this mission, B1063, landed successfully for the seventh time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing burn.
There you can see stage 1 has lit one engine, the center engine, to prepare for landing on our drone ship.
Stage
we can start to see in the background here.
Stage 1 landing light deploy. Stage 1 landing is confirmed.
All right, and as you can see there, Falcon 9 has landed. This marks SpaceX's 58th first stage landing on our drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You, and our 39th launch of this year.
Musk posted a tweet about the SpaceX logo with information I hadn't known nor picked up on before. He said the swoop of the X is meant to represent the rocket's arc to orbit. The Royal Caribbean Group, who run the cruise ships, posted a tweet related to Starlink. They said, "We've just announced our plan to implement SpaceX's Starlink, making us the first in the cruise industry to adopt the technology. The game-changing high-speed internet will be deployed on Royal Caribbean Celebrity Cruise and Silver Sea ships." Royal Caribbean had been testing Starlink for some time and are very happy with it, and they also posted this article along with the tweet. They also said the installation is slated to be completed by the end of the first quarter of 2023. Zach Golden asked Elon Musk a question on Twitter about the booster QD connector. He asked, "Hey Elon Musk, why can't the booster QD on the orbital launch mount be used to start the Center 13 engines? In other words, the launch mount would be responsible for starting all 33 engines instead of just the outer 20. COPVs would only be used for boost back and landing burns." Musk responded and said, "Agreed, we recently made this change and many others. An intense effort is underway to achieve robust engine containment in case of RUD to protect booster, other engines and launch ring." Somebody posted an infographic showing the scale of Starship versus all the other rockets ever produced. Musk responded with, "It will grow by at least 5 to 10 meters over time." Taking a look at the road and beach closures, some more dates were added. "We were expecting testing on Monday and they did something, but no testing happened. They sent out an overpressure notice for Tuesday indicating a static fire, but the road closure was cancelled in the end. They also sent out a notice yesterday and have a closure for today, Wednesday 31st, hopefully for some more testing. In addition, they've added possible closures for tomorrow, Thursday 1st and next week with Tuesday 6th and Wednesday 7th. The final thing to share before we finish the video, we have another updated Starbase production diagram to take a look at thanks to Brendan Lewis. This video is unlike any other where we actually don't have anything from Starbase to take a look at. Hopefully in the next video there will be some content, but for this video there is not, and hence why it's so short. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.